As you know, my name is W. Clement Stone. As general manager of the Napoleon Hill Associates, it is my privilege to once again introduce you to Napoleon Hill, the author of How to Raise Your Own Salary, Think and Grow Rich, and many other inspirational books. This is another in a series of inspirational talks by Napoleon Hill. What do you want? Money? Anything money can buy? A healthy body? A healthy mind? Happiness? Are you seeking higher spiritual values? Anything you desire is available if you follow the Napoleon Hill formula. Success is yours if you are ready. And now, I share with you Napoleon Hill.
How do you do? I'm very happy to have this personal visit with you. Won't you be seated, please? We have now come to our 11th visit, where I shall present Creative Vision, the success principle which is responsible for the building of all of our plans, aims, and purposes. It has been said that the imagination is the workshop wherein we fashion the purposes of our brain and the ideals of our soul. I do not know of a better definition of imagination than this. There are two forms of imagination. First, there is synthetic imagination, which consists of organizing and putting together of recognized ideas, concepts, and facts arranged in a new combination. Very seldom does anyone create an idea or anything else absolutely new. Nearly everything known to civilization is but a combination of something that is old. Secondly, there is creative imagination, which operates through the sixth sense and has its base in the subconscious section of the brain and serves as the exclusive medium through which basically new ideas or facts are revealed. Let me give you some examples of synthetic imagination in action. One, Edison's invention of the incandescent electric lamp was the creation of synthetic imagination because it was created by bringing together in a new combination two old and well-known principles. Two, Clarence Saunders' idea on which the Piggly Wiggly store system was based was the result of synthetic imagination because he merely borrowed the self-help cafeteria plan and introduced it into the grocery store business. But despite the simplicity of the plan, it is said to have yielded its organizer $4 million during the first 4 years after it was put to work. Three, Henry Ford's first automobile was created through synthetic imagination by the simple procedure of bringing together the well-known method of transportation, the horse and buggy, and the steam-propelled thrashing machine. Both ideas were old, but it remained for Henry Ford to combine them in a new method of use, and he made himself the most distinguished industrialist of his era by his achievement, not to mention a fabulous fortune. Four, the man who dipped a hunk of ice cream in chocolate, placed a stick in it for a handle, and called it Eskimo pie, used synthetic imagination and started a new industry which still has a widespread outlet and grosses annually a huge sum. It is safe to assume that the creator of this simple plan of merchandising was well compensated for his use of his synthetic imagination. Five, F.W. Woolworth made use of synthetic imagination by the simple procedure of setting up a retail store in which a large variety of merchandise retailing at 5 and 10 cents per item was offered to the public, and lived to see his merchandising innovation start a series of similar retail stores which gross annually many millions of dollars in sales and made Woolworth rich in the bargain. Now, I shall give you some examples of creative imagination. One, Edison's invention of the phonograph was the outgrowth of creative imagination because no part of his invention had ever been known or used previously. Two, Signor Marconi's invention of wireless communication was also the outgrowth of creative imagination because it was based on basically new ideas which never had been used previously. He was the first to discover the means by which the ether could be made to take the place of wires in the transmission of sound. Three, Madame Curie's discovery of radium was also the outgrowth of creative imagination because no one before her had ever revealed either the actual existence of radium or the method by which it could be recovered or refined. 4, Wilbur and Orville Wright's perfection of the modern airplane was partly the result of creative imagination and partly the result of synthetic imagination, because others, previous to their time, had discovered some of the ideas they used successfully, but they were the first to coordinate those ideas, so they worked. 5, Robert G. Letourneau made effective use of creative imagination by building heavy dirt-removing machinery, which involved ideas never before used, although he was practically unskilled in engineering and had very little schooling of any kind. I worked with Mr. Letourneau for a year and a half, during which I saw him in action many times when he was drawing entirely upon the faculty of creative imagination and receiving his ideas from sources outside of his own immediate education or knowledge. Now let me give you a few suggestions as to how you may be able to make profitable use of your imagination, keeping in mind that the faculty of your imagination, like every other faculty of your mind, becomes stale through disuse and alert through use. 1, create a system of merchandising which can be carried on by the operators of gasoline filling stations throughout the nation, and you may make your idea yield you more profit than Clarence Saunders made from his Piggly Wiggly store plan. Perhaps the system would consist of items which could be dispensed by coin in the slot machines. 2, create a plan or system which will cause motorists to be as courteous and thoughtful of others on the highway as they are in their own homes, and you may cut down the outrageous death rate by automobile accidents and make yourself both popular and rich. Perhaps you might add to this idea some plan of engineering by which public highways would be so operated as to force motorists to drive with greater care. And you might also create some practical plan by which motorists of good reputation would be deputized as auxiliary traffic officers with two-way radios in their cars and authority to give tickets and make arrests. 3, create a satisfactory substitute for cigarettes, and you may make yourself richer than you need to be. 4, give me an acceptable method for taking these principles of success to children of the graded school age, and I will tell you how to make yourself rich both in money and in happiness, which comes from contributions of service which benefit posterity by improving the youth. Give me a plan which will arouse and alert people to recognize and make use of the potential of their own minds, and I will give you a job for the remainder of your life at pay which perhaps you never dreamed of getting. 6, bring me an acceptable storybook slanted to the interest of children from 6 to 12 years of age, based upon the 17 principles of the science of success, and I will ensure the publication and distribution of the book on a scale which will make you richer than you need to be. This idea probably can be best refined through the mind of a woman who understands children, loves them, and can speak in terms that will get their attention. And right here, in case you have not already recognized the fact, I am bringing you very near the point where people sometimes tune in on their creative imagination and come up with ideas which benefit great numbers of people and make themselves popular and rich. I am going to give you these suggestions solely as inspiration intended to introduce you to your faculty of creative imagination. All the good ideas have been used up, did I hear you say? Quite to the contrary, the best ideas are yet to be revealed and put into the service of mankind. There are no more opportunities to become rich, did I hear you say? Listen, please, for I have an answer for this one. The Napoleon Hill Associates are engaged in the business of helping people with sound ideas to bring them forth and give them to the world in return for riches. If you have an idea you think is good, write me about it, and I will give you my opinion of it. If you have a sound idea which you think will benefit those with whom or for whom you work, write me about it, and I will tell you what to do with it. If you have discovered a better way of doing anything, write me about it, and I will offer you suggestions for benefiting by your discovery. If you will give me an acceptable plan for influencing married people to adopt and use the mastermind principle in their domestic relations, you may benefit many millions of people in homes where harmony does not now prevail, and to make for yourself a reputation worthy of a king's ransom. If you have a better idea or plan for the use of salesmen in any field of selling, your idea may help millions of salesmen to increase their incomes and bring you a reward worthy of the value of your idea. If you can create an idea which will help retail store owners to display their merchandise to better advantage so as to increase their sales, write me about your idea, and if I believe it sound, I will tell you what to do with it. I am still talking to you about exercising your faculty of imagination, but I am limited as to the number of ideas I can give you in so short a time. But I will give you some more useful ideas in my next visit. Imagination is a trait which becomes alert only by constant action based on the success principles I have described in these visits. You are the one who must supply this action.